Hey, what's going on, Wealth Giants? Ryan here. Today, we're going to be talking about a list of things I personally look for when I am investing in companies. Before I even consider pressing that buy button, I have to know what these answers are and why they are the way they are. But also remember, I am just a YouTuber. I'm not a financial advisor. So keep that in mind. All that great stuff that other YouTubers say when they talk about finances. Don't hold me accountable for your mistakes. All right. That's basically what I'm telling you. So these are 8 things that I personally look for. I have to know these things before I press the buy button. And the first thing is, what does the company do to make money? Money, you know, the thing that you invest in this company to make you. You have to know. You have to be like, okay, well, we have Apple. What's their main source of income? Well, it's the iPhone, you know, everybody knows this. But, you know, what if you want to invest in something that not everybody talks about? Well, what's their main source of income? Facebook, ad revenue, 90%+ of their income is through ads. If you can't answer this question, you shouldn't even consider touching the buy button, all right? Number 2, are they making more money? Are they becoming more and more profitable? Are they increasing their revenue year over year? You got to answer this question. You can do this by looking at their income statement, all right? Look at their revenue. Look at their net income. Look at their profits. Look at their EBITDA. You got to answer the question of, are they increasing these numbers? Now, sometimes the revenue is increasing while their profits are decreasing or staying consistently negative, all right? Tesla was that way for a while. Are they just going through a phase kind of like Amazon? Amazon did that. Before they became profitable, they were losing money. Amazon's a great company, but you know, there was a good chance that this company wasn't going to be successful because they were losing money. Ask yourself, is this the company of the next Amazon if they are losing money? Who knows? So answer the question, are they becoming consecutively more and more profitable or increasing their revenue at least? The third thing, what are their assets versus liabilities? Do they have more assets than liabilities? Are they in debt to the point where they can never crawl out of the hole that they dug themselves? On their balance sheet, look at how much cash they have on hand, especially right now. That is a big deal, all right? A lot of companies, they have had to shut down, like complete KO, you know, Carnival Cruise Line, nada, all right? Their boats are docked. Nobody's going on vacation right now. Nobody wants to sit on a petri dish in the middle of the ocean and say, I like this. You know, do they have enough cash on hand in case an emergency that stops their production or temporarily damages it or slows it down? Do they have enough cash to make up for it? Now, the fourth thing, what is their cash flow? Is it positive? Is it negative? Look at their cash flow statement, all right? When you look at their cash flow statement, you can see, all right, they're slowly losing money. But is that a bad thing? You know, you got to answer the question of why are they losing money, all right? Tesla, they've been losing money for a while, but now they're starting to make money. If you look at Amazon, they were kind of in debt. They were losing money quarter over quarter, year over year. But because they were able to maintain and control, they are now one of the biggest companies in the world. So look at their cash flow statement and say, well, we have this company. They're making money. That's great. They're losing money. Well, why? Is it just because they're trying to grow their business? Is it because they're trying to expand? If that's the case, and that's the only reason why, and if they stopped expanding, they would start being a positive cash flow, then sure, maybe you should invest in them. But if they're bleeding money to the point where they might just go out of business, probably a company you should avoid. All right, moving on to number 5. So what you're going to do is find out whether or not you are overpaying or you're getting the company for a discounted price. And how you do this is you take all the variables that are given to you and you're gonna calculate the PE ratio. And you're gonna look at the forward and trailing PE ratio. Now, if you're not sure about these and you wanna figure out how it all works, the last video I made was about the forward and trailing PE ratio. So I'll leave a link up above. Click on that if you wanna learn more about it and you wanna, I'll also leave a link in the description below. So the PE ratio is basically the fair price evaluator of a company. It helps you understand whether or not you're overpaying or underpaying for a company. And what you do is you take the PE ratio and you compare it to its industry's average as well as its closest competitors and its competition and see where it stands with it. Now, if it's below the industry's average or its closest competitors, you're getting it for a discount. But be warned, if a company is buying back its outstanding shares, there is a chance that this PE ratio that you are looking at could be manipulated by the company, because as they buy back outstanding shares, this causes the PE ratio to go down, which makes it look undervalued. But really, because they've been buying back shares, it's actually not moved at all, essentially. Going on to number six, what you want to do is you want to look at their chief officers, their CEO, their CFO. You want to see their leadership team. You want to know who they are, how long they've been in the industry, whether or not they left the last company they were with better than when they found it. You want to see who they are and whether or not they can handle an economy that is going through hard times and good times, that they can grow a company. I'm investing in Uber. Uber, they have a lot of cool things and they have a lot of bad things about them, but one of the biggest selling points for them, for me, is their CEO, Dara. Dara came from Expedia. He came there and he made it better than when he found it, and then he left and came to Uber. Okay, so I know he has the experience. He has the experience in the travel industry. Okay, Expedia, all travel, Uber, travel, you know, transportation. When you're looking at a company, you want to make sure that the leaders know what they're doing and can get you or your investment to where you want it to be. All right, let's move on to number seven. When you invest in a company, know the risks of that company. All right, all publicly traded companies are required by the SEC to show all investors what the risks are involved when you invest in their company. All right, you can find these on the 10Ks and the 10Qs, and they are plain as day listed. There are tons of risks with every company. Tesla. Tesla has the risks of its CEO. Its CEO, Elon Musk. And no, it's not his tweets. It is the fact that he is a CEO of Tesla as well as SpaceX. He has got his attention divided up amongst two companies. Okay, that is a risk. So you must know the risks. Look at the 10Ks, look at the 10Qs. And finally, number eight, know when to sell before you buy. Do not become emotionally attached to the company. Do not become emotionally attached to this stock, all right? The stock is there to make you money. It is not a relationship. It is not,
you are mine and I am yours. Forever we shall be joined at the hip.
No. It's not that way. This is the one relationship you can dump as soon as it reaches its goal. You don't want to not know at what point you are going to sell. You're not going to be like, I bought in and it's gone up, but should I sell or should I stay? No, you already know at the point you will sell, so you will stay in until it reaches that point. Unless during one of the quarterly reports or the annual reports, you sit there and say, huh, this company is not going in the direction I think it or thought it was going to go in, I'm going to sell out at this market cap instead. So reduce the stress, know when to sell before you buy, and do not become emotionally attached. All right, so let's go ahead and recap. First thing we want to know is, how do they make money and can they maintain relevance during economical change? Second thing we want to see is their income statement. Make sure that they are becoming more profitable and that their revenue is increasing year over year. Third thing we want to look at is their balance sheet. Make sure that they have enough cash on hand that can push them through economical challenges for their company. Also, that they have more assets than liabilities. Liabilities. Okay, number four, you want to look at their cash flow statement. Make sure that they are cash flow positive. If they are cash flow negative, is it because they are pushing their company to grow? If that is the case, then you make your decision. Number five, are they appropriately valued at that price point that they are at? You can know this through the PE ratios. If you want to know a little bit more about PE ratios, hit the link above or in the description below. Number six, you got to know who the leader is. Okay, number seven, you need to know the risks of the company. Look at the 10Ks and the 10Qs. And finally, know when to sell before you buy, and you will maintain a happy life. With that said, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider tapping that like button for the YouTube algorithm. Helps people like yourself find my videos here on YouTube. Also, if you want to see more videos like this, please consider hitting that subscribe button over to my right. It's an ugly mug, looks just like this one. It's the only time you'll ever be able to hit my face, and I will see you guys next time.